This film is developed in ECN-2. And this is developed in C41. Can you tell the difference? Let me go a few days back and start from the beginning. A couple of weeks ago I decided to head outside with the sole purpose of comparing these two different processes. After reading all the articles and watching the videos that claim how different the two processes are and that cinema film should only be developed in ECN2 chemistry if you want the best possible results, I wanted to test things out and see for myself how big of a difference there is between the two of them. So I set out to try a simple test. I decided to use two of my Canon EOS cameras, the 50E and the 600, along with two Zeiss lenses, the 28 and the 50mm. The idea was to shoot the exact same scenes, alternating between the two cameras, and then developing one of the rolls at the lab in ECN2 chemistry and the other at home, cross-processed in C41. I shot a variety of scenes locally, both day and night, and the following day I set up a couple of still life shots using studio lights to see how the two processes are going to affect the final results. After finishing the rolls, I sent one of them at the lab to be processed in ECN2 chemicals and proceeded developing the other one at home as C41. I'm using a water bath with a sous vide temperature controller to keep the temperatures as accurate and consistent as possible, and to get rid of the rendered layer I'm using the bicarbonate soda method at the beginning along with a final scrub before the stabilizer. Once I had all the negatives, I proceeded scanning them with my DSLR setup. And now with the files ready, let's jump into Lightroom and have a look at the results. After scanning both rolls, I labeled all the ECN2 files with blue color and the C41 files with red color. One thing I noticed both while scanning and while seeing the negatives in Lightroom is that the ECN2 negative looks a bit flatter, while the C41 looks more contrasty with a heavier orange cast. I'm going to white balance the image first by using the border of the film as a sample and then hit Ctrl+N to open up Negative Lab Pro. To start with, I'm going to leave the settings as they are, with Frontier selected as the color model and the pre-saturation at 3, which is the default setting. Border buffer is at 3%, which is enough to ignore the black border, and let's hit Convert. Okay. The image looks fairly neutral to me. I don't want to touch any of the settings at this point. I want to go ahead and do the same with the ECN2 file. Alright. That looks fairly similar, although a tad darker. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same with the rest of the files and see if we can get any major differences before I start playing with the sliders. I went on and converted all the negatives, and to my surprise the files look fairly similar to each other. If I hadn't labeled the images, it would be almost impossible for me to tell the difference. After what I've read about the ECN2 process, I was expecting something more prominent right from the start. But I don't wanna jump into conclusions too early. Let's see what we can do with the files first. One thing I was interested to see in this test is how does C41 hold up in terms of dynamic range? How much information does it keep in the highlights and shadows? One of the main advantages that the ECN2 process is supposed to give you is a flatter image, so I was interested to see this difference. So let's play a bit with the highlights and the shadows. I'm going to try the C41 version first. There is quite a big difference in stops of light between the sky and the shadow parts of this image, so it'll be a good example. If I drag the highlights to the left, I can see there's plenty of information still in the scan, nothing lost there. Let's see the shadows. Same here, plenty of detail that you can easily recover. Keep in mind, I'm not trying to edit the image to my liking at this point, I'm just interested to see the film's limits. Let's try the ECN2 now. Well, no difference whatsoever, honestly, I cannot see anything noticeable. There are minor color and light differences between the two images, which can be a result of slight inaccuracies of the two cameras or a small change in lights, as these images were taken a minute or two apart. It just looks trivial. I couldn't possibly attribute any of these minor differences to a specific reason. Okay, I want to head on to the still life images that I set up to see how the two films compare in this scenario. I set up a quick product shot with this bottle of scotch. Key light is on the right side through a sheet of diffusion, and there is a second light on the other side, which is mainly for the background. These look very similar to each other. Again, I'm struggling to see any major differences, something that would set one process apart. The slight color or light differences can be attributed to a number of reasons, and they are so minor that can easily be matched between the two images. Let me bring up quickly a digital version of this image. When I did the shoot, I used my DSLR with the same lens to get a digital capture, just to have a more neutral base image to compare to. This is the digital RAW file without any editing, so you can see how it looks compared to the film. Keep in mind that color negative film usually needs some further color corrections, but the starting point looks good to me, and the results that I got from the two different processes don't look worlds apart. Now let's have a look at one more image from the roll. At this point, to be honest with you, I thought that maybe something is wrong, maybe there is another reason that the two negatives look so similar to each other. I wanted to eliminate the possibility of negative lab probe being the issue, so I picked up this frame, which looked somewhat different after being converted with negative lab probe, and did a manual conversion of the two files in Photoshop. I proceeded to edit the two photos as if they were two completely different scenes. I didn't want to just copy the edits from one image to the other. So these are the images I ended up with. Can you tell which is which? Do you see any difference that would give away one film process versus the other? Honestly, what I see are two images that share many similarities and only a few differences. As I said in the beginning, these rolls were shot with similar cameras, with the same lenses and lighting conditions, but they didn't do this test in a lab environment. There is always the possibility of slight variances, whether in terms of shooting or developing the film. And this is the reason I didn't want to try and match the two files at the end. My goal was to see if I can find a profound difference between the two processes in everyday use, and after seeing the results, I can only see minor differences. Nothing major or repeatable between the two rolls. This leaves me with the conclusion that I'm not missing out on any of the qualities of cinema film when choosing to cross-process it in C41 at home. A process that yields high quality results with a very low cost that makes shooting cinema films even more attractive. Now that being said, I always try to keep an open mind to different possibilities or errors in my process. If you have done anything similar comparing the two processes and have different results to report, please let me know in the comments down below. Or if you believe that the scanning or converting part didn't reveal the different traits of the ECN-2 process that Zilberzals and other labs are claiming that it has, then let me know with your findings. I'm keen to continue this conversation in the comments, and feel free to check out more examples from this comparison in my blog post. Link is in the description. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.